Through that. Now, the Reserve Bank is well on its way to kicking its war against non-performing assets up a notch, and a list of bad loans over which the insolvency and bankruptcy code will be initiated will be released soon. That's the word in from the Finance Minister, who met with bankers to take stock of various issues from GST preparedness to cyber security and, of course, NPAs. Take a look.
As Finance Minister Arun Jaitley met with the heads of public sector banks, bad loans were on top of the agenda. No surprise there, since the quantum of stressed assets has crossed 10 lakh crore rupees. With speedy resolution becoming the order of the day, the RBI will soon use the newest weapon in its arsenal, the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code.
The RBI is at a fairly advanced stage of preparing a list of those debtors where a resolution is required through the IBC process. And you will shortly be hearing about it. There are already about 81 cases that have been filed under the IBC. Of these 81 cases, 18 cases have been initiated by the financial creditors. These are already before the NCLT. And since bulk of the NPAs, about 70%, are either in a consortium or in a multiple banking arrangement, a speedy resolution for them is required.
One of the important components was to enhance the size and the scope of oversight committee, also the identification of such accounts which can be quickly taken up under the process.
This quick action is necessary because while public sector banks together posted operating profits of 1.5 lakh crore rupees in FY17, the aggregate net profit after accounting for provisioning, including bad debts, fell to 574 crore rupees. But the conversation was not restricted to bad loans. Weak credit growth has been a cause for concern, but the minister is convinced banks are doing their best to reverse this trend and that banks have done fairly well on transmitting any rate cuts by the RBI to customers over the last 6 to 8 months.
The banks are making their best effort through their infrastructure that is available to them to give the credit whenever asked for. But that's a part of the overall demand in the economy also. It's not related to banks alone.
Bank consolidation, which has emerged as a major theme, was not on the agenda. But one can expect some forward movement on this front soon.
I can tell you we are actively working in that direction. I can't give you further details because some of these details are price sensitive. But you can take it that there is a movement going on in that direction.
Dealing with NPAs was the major concern highlighted by banks, where banks said that huge stress assets are actually burdening their books, though RBI did assure that they are soon going to make the guidelines public. Banks are doing their bit. Very clearly, another agenda where banks agreed that there is a major challenge and lapse on the case of cyber security, where a possible solution could be creation of a separate computer emergency response team dedicated for the financial institutions. Meanwhile, on GST preparedness, there was a special session with the Revenue Secretary, where Revenue Secretary did highlight and made it clear to the banks that they will have to register in each and every state and be prepared for a July 1 rollout. In New Delhi, Timsi Jaipuria.